Before your site goes live, you want to make sure everything works perfectly. That's where publishing to staging and production come in. Think of staging as your draft site, where you can test functionality, gather feedback, and fine-tune your design. It's a safe space to catch any issues before the big launch. In production, that's where your site goes live on a custom domain, ready for the world to see. Together, these tools give you the confidence to publish your site seamlessly. In this video, we'll break down publishing to staging, as well as publishing to production. And finally, we'll walk through a typical workflow in Webflow from building to launching your site. And for enterprise users, check out our separate video on publishing for enterprise sites. Let's start with staging. There's a key difference between previewing and staging your site. Previewing is quick. Click the play button at the top left to see how your site looks and functions directly within Webflow. You can test viewport widths, animations, and more, then tweak as needed. Staging takes it a step further. It creates a draft version of your site on a webflow.io domain where you can test custom code, check responsiveness across devices, and share the link for feedback. To find your staging subdomain, head to your site settings and go to publishing. By default, Webflow generates a subdomain for you, but you can customize it to whatever you want. Publishing to staging is simple. You can do this from your site settings or right from the canvas. Go up to publish, make sure your webflow.io domain is selected, and publish. Your site is now live in your staging environment. Don't worry though, publishing to staging won't impact your production site, so it's the perfect place to experiment. Here are some quick tips to make the most of staging. First, test on multiple devices to ensure your content and design is viewable and responds fluidly. Second, be sure to double-check links, forms, and custom code. And don't forget to share the staging link to gather feedback and refine as needed. Now let's move on to publishing to production. When you're ready to go live, you can publish your site to a custom domain, like yourdomain.com, with Webflow hosting. This includes fast loading times and SSL encryption for secure browsing. To set this up, connect an existing domain to your Webflow site or purchase a new domain directly through Webflow. And once your domain is set up, same thing as for staging, from the site settings or the canvas, go up to publish, and this time make sure to select your custom domain and publish. Now your site is live on production. Pro tip, if you're making changes to individual CMS items, you can use single item publishing to update just that item without affecting the rest of your site. For full site publishing, it's important to control who has access. In roles and permissions, you can toggle publishing access for specific team members, ensuring only authorized users can publish your entire site. So that's production. Next part. Here's a typical publishing workflow in Webflow. Design and build your site in Webflow using preview mode to test as you go. When you're ready, publish to staging and test everything. Gather feedback, make refinements, and restage as needed. Once everything's perfect, publish to production, your custom domain, for the world to see. And remember, this process, it's iterative. If something's not right, you can always tweak, restage, and republish. For more tips and guides, check out Webflow University and the Help Center. And if you're a customer on an enterprise plan, don't forget to watch our video on the enterprise publishing workflow. That's an overview of publishing in Webflow.